Game Devs Play Games. Hey. We play games and talk game design, and we're playing Steredenn.
Usually.
Kapow. Let's do this. Kapow. Usually. That would be the hope, is that we talk game design. That's kind of our shtick.
Or
if you don't know already.
Yeah.
I don't know where I was trying to go with it.
I don't know. You're just being a jerk for the sake
usually
of
talk game design, usually play Steredenn, except not really.
The worst.
So last we left off, Nathan died. And the time before that he also died.
But this,
maybe this time
I will not die ever.
You know, it's entirely possible. Well, hey, if we end the episode before you die,
then technically
you will just have never died.
That's fair. Because and that will be the first time that I've... Yeah, lasers!
Ooh, wait. Do you just have this weapon?
Yes.
Does it have ammo?
Nope.
What? This is amazing!
It's not as good as it seems. It's very good. I'm not saying it's bad. But, like, for instance, the bullets are actually more powerful. Well,
I mean, that's fair, but I feel like with the laser, it's a lot easier to get contact on things.
It is much easier, and that's why I use it, especially to chew through those smaller guys.
Absolutely.
Plus, it is just very satisfying.
In some ways, this game sort of reminds me of our playthrough of Downwell. Mostly, I guess, with like the variety of weapon types, right? Like,
maybe. I wasn't there.
I mean, I know you've played down well.
A lot, but you play it without me.
We can play it again.
Mm.
I was really happy with our playthrough with me and Geek Arius, because I got to the end and I almost actually, well, maybe not almost beat him, but I got farther than I had ever gotten before.
You might be surprised. You might have not been as close to beating him as you thought, because that guy has, like,
He goes through every single zone you've been through before.
Yes, yeah, it takes a really long time.
Yeah, maybe this wasn't in our playthrough, but in one of my personal playthroughs of Downwell, I got to the point where you're in that, like, underworld, like, just past the water zone, and you have, like...
Ah.
So close, man. But anyway, Steredenn.
So there's a... the one problem that I do have is there's certain... Oh, I want that. I don't know what it is, but I want it.
Dude, I want that.
Super
flamethrower.
Oh, no, flamethrower. I misread. So this is a good compliment.
Flamethrowers don't work in space.
Did you meet the 80s? Yes, they do.
Touché.
So look at this. Just chew through all the asteroids. Yeah, that's why that weapon's really good.
I really like that they don't
you do
block
slower,
the shots.
Though.
It does seem like enemies block the shots, but other obstacles don't. So asteroids.
It
I
might
guess.
Be. It might also just be because they're dying too quickly.
That's true. So how many weapons can you hold at once?
Just two.
Just two. So did you just like replace your default gun?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, for a flamethrower, I probably would have too.
It's a dangerous weapon, but it's very satisfying. It's actually very, very, very powerful too.
How's it dangerous?
Because I have to be this close.
Okay, that's fair. See, but I feel like in a lot of bullet hells, being close is not necessarily bad, because at least it means you have space to back up if you're, like, being hunted down by bullets.
That's actually interesting you bring that up, because that is an important tactic. However, it works the other way around, weirdly enough, depending on what it is you're fighting.
In this game specifically?
In some bullet hells. It's ah, crap. Ah, so close to just not getting hit ever. And then I get hit twice. At this point, I can just go offense and not worry about my health.
Yeah, that's fair.
Because when you get hit, you lose your multiplier to a certain degree. Or I don't know, something like that.
I will say, there are a lot of, like, flashing lights going on, like when you take damage or when something explodes, which certainly emphasizes that, hey, this thing is exploding. But do you ever find it to be a little, like, overwhelming?
No. The only times that I've ever been a little overwhelmed... Oh, I never seen that. Look at the
thing in the background.
Yeah,
that is pretty sweet. Like space colony on a giant asteroid.
So cool. It's like a castle. It's like a castle. Hey, yeah, got it. So your upgrades. Actually, did I? No, I didn't screw myself. Good.
Well.
So I have two upgrades for energy now. I got the ray gun.
Ooh.
That's always shooting. As long as I have my energy weapon out, this little bot's also there shooting, and I have where energy weapons deal extra damage. So man, seriously.
I always like little bots like that that hang out at your side. That's definitely a staple of bullet hells.
Yes, it is.
I don't know where those first came about.
Probably, if I had to guess, something like R-Type. I think R-Type did have little ships that fall. Maybe I'm wrong. Somebody who's like a huge fan of R-Type right now is watching and going, "You're an idiot." No, it doesn't. And you know what? I'm sorry. Yes, this is the best. This is where the laser is the best.
Yeah.
All your ship.
I was going to say, just because we're game designers doesn't mean we necessarily know everything about games. But I suppose that is sort of like...
Jesus! Yes. That's why the flamethrower is dangerous.
Yeah.
My particles are more powerful.
You totally got this. Right?
How many hits can I...
You can take three more.
Whoa.
Now, do...
Really?
Enemy ships deal, like, varying damage, or is it always, like, one hit equals one dot?
No, there are different... Like, I did just get hit for one, but...
I guess, like, the giant laser that hit you at the end of our last episode probably...
Easily two, maybe more.
I was gonna say, I wouldn't be surprised if it was something like five.
I tried to move. I died the same way last time. I saw it and I was like, "Oh, I'm gonna get out of the way."
I mean, it's a good
and
way to
I
die.
And then I didn't get out of the way. How much time do we have left?
Well, we still have 3.5 minutes, so I don't know.
I have an idea.
Check out some of these other bosses, or just fight the same one again.
Fight that one guy that I can't seem to beat. I want to fight you.
Yeah, that's the thing I'm the most curious about, are what some of the bigger...
Oh, because I haven't beat him, I can't face against him yet? Fair enough.
Oh, so you know who he is, but... Okay, so that kind of negates the one thing that we talked about being able to just practice like crazy against some of these bosses.
Yeah. I never actually got to see what this did. So go ahead and use this gun. I feel like you were going to ask something.
I don't know.
Oh, it didn't actually give me the... I must have hit the wrong button.
Unless you gave him that gun.
No, that's not possible. Weird. You're stupid for thinking that. All right.
Oh,
okay.
You have to choose one.
First gun. And then... Wait, that was my super gun. All right, wait. Charger is my first gun. And Reflectors is my second.
Oh, that's a gun.
All right. Well, it is awesome. It's incredibly powerful, but it will get you hurt a lot more than you think it would because it doesn't last for very long.
Hmm.
Kapah!
That's interesting. I would have thought that the reflector would just kind of like always be out since it doesn't cover the whole area, right?
It does this.
Yeah, so do you control which direction it's facing?
Yes. But see, that's the problem. See, it has ammo to it, and it takes. So it's whatever direction I'm moving that it goes in.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, I guess it would be a little weird if it expected you to use two joysticks.
I want to talk about it. I just wasn't really paying attention. See, but the reflector, man, I love it, but it would get me killed so often. So this guy can be charged up for like different levels.
Huh.
So I could shoot tiny ones, medium ones. That is a really nifty weapon.
Definitely, like, the worst weapon for swarms.
Yes,
but... It looks like those charge shots do a lot of damage to them.
I kind of wish that there was a, a health bar so I knew. But considering he's already almost dead...
Yeah, I mean, at least they kind of give you a flicker of, his little skull above his head.
So you kind of have an idea, and that's important.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he went down pretty fast there, like, once I was actually hitting him with those things. And see, a gun like that can be kind of cool, because since I had to charge it up, there's, like, one upgrade where while you're not shooting, you'll charge up a shield to protect yourself.
Okay.
So for weapons that are semi-automatic like that, you can actually take... If you get the right stuff, you can get a good build going on, where you can just wreck it. So... There are a lot of possibilities and combinations with weapons and upgrades and stuff, and I think that's one reason that the game has a lot of replayability, because I've already found, like, two weapons that I've never seen before, just playing through this, just now.
That's awesome. I think that's definitely one of the things that, like, modern... I guess really any roguelike game, but modern games in general are taking a lot of... Especially modern indie games are taking a lot of, like, inspiration from, but also benefiting greatly from, because, like, replayability is key nowadays, especially shorter games.
Yeah.
So I really appreciate that variety.
So we brought this up earlier. So cool. Oh, wow, look at that. I think that almost beat my score.
I just like the guy named YV with the YV icon.
Oh, that's awesome. That guy. And then if you press the right bumper, you can focus on whoever's first. And look at that. Look at all those people with the same score. We were talking about it. We're like, I think that's the most amount that...
The largest integer that the system can hold. I'm not totally sure, because I'm not really a programmer, even if I pretend like it sometimes, but it all depends on how they're storing the data.
But regardless,
it's
2
cool
billion.
To see people with the max score, though. Does this change every day, or is this like...
I think this is in general.
Okay, so it's just a lifetime.
But I could be... I mean, it just says scores, it doesn't specify, but I could be wrong. And so, I mean, honestly, folks, that's pretty much what Steredenn has. It's the gist of it. It got to see a few bosses, and you could see more if you played and did better than I do, because I suck at this game. I like it. I'm just not good at it. So, that's... I just thought that the combination of roguelike and bullet hell is just, it's really cool. It seems like a no-brainer.
Yeah. It actually kind of reminds me of our playthrough of Bunker Punks, where it was basically a combination of roguelike and first-person shooter. And it was like, this works surprisingly, well, not even surprisingly, it just works really well together.
Yeah, it works, and you would think, oh man, this should be a thing more often.
I guess... Bunker Punks was technically a Twitch shooter, which you know a little bit more about than Geekarius did, but...
Oh. Oh, no.
But it's fun either way.
So that's about all I got for it. I can say, I don't know, I've sank, like, probably 10, 15 hours or whatever into the game, and... It's simple enough that's like there's not a whole lot to talk about except for what we have, and then after that it's just a matter of experiencing it.
It's a very honest, straightforward, and fun bullet hell.
That's just absolutely.
They know exactly what they wanted to be. I think they did a good job.
They wanted to rock out in space is what they wanted, man.
Exactly.
I really wish that there was like a guy on my ship playing guitar, like Mad Max style, through space.
Just like standing on top wearing a spacesuit.
That'd be awesome. Or no spacesuit and just, you know, pasting it.
Blowing in the space wind.
Thank you
for watching, everyone. Be sure to vote on what you want us to play next, whether it be more Steredenn or whatever else is up there.
Mm-hmm.
And if you haven't noticed, if you haven't watched our Overland playthrough, the voting system is changing a little bit in that the options to vote are basically going to be for the same for every game that we play during this recording session. So we played Overland and we played Steredenn this recording session. So whatever you guys vote for the most is what we're going to play next, plus probably whatever else we have spare time to play.
Vagrant Story. I'm just...
That's going to be the game that... It gets put up
I just really
want
to play that game. I guess that's my excuse. God, I miss Vagrant Story.
Question of the day on Steredenn is, what do you guys think about the game in general? I mean, whether you've played it yourself or your only experience is like me and only watching this playthrough, what are your impressions? What do you think the game's greatest strengths are, and what do you think they could use more of?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Wow, I don't generally get that kind of praise from you.
Jeez, for nothing, ever.
Thank you for watching, everyone.
See you.